Hey guys, welcome to Jash Outline. This video is about Redmi Note 8 Pro camera review. So, let's get started.
Redmi Note 8 Pro comes with quad camera system. The primary lens is of 64 megapixel with aperture f1.8. The secondary lens is of 8 megapixel with aperture f2.2, which acts as a wide angle lens. Third lens is of 2 megapixel, which used as a depth sensor. And the fourth lens, which is of 2 megapixel, used for macro photography. The selfie camera of Redmi Note 8 Pro is of 20 megapixel with aperture f2.0. In day-to-day normal light conditions, the camera performs really good. The images taken using this mobile gives you really good pictures, which has a lot of details, sharpness and white balance, mostly on point. The dynamic range on this mobile is really good when compared to mobiles up to 30K range. The 64 megapixel mode gives you really good pictures and really good details when you compare with other 64MP mobiles. When you zoom into pictures, it preserves details most of the times, but one thing is clear that 64MP camera will not take more light into the sensor when compared to the standard 16 megapixel shot. When a picture taken using 16 megapixel mode, it uses pixel binning technology so that it will gather a lot of light, combining each 4 pixels into 1 pixel, whereas 64 megapixel mode, the pixel binning technology does not perform. Where in 64 megapixel shots, you get much more dull or dark images when you compare it to the 16 megapixel. Anyways, you can get light into those images while post-processing. But to the normal eye, 16 megapixel image is more than enough and you will love the images. But sometimes the images taken by Redmi Note 8 Pro slightly tends towards little warmer side. This will not happen every time, but it happens sometimes and that's annoying. Portrait shots on this mobile is quite good. But sometimes you need to maintain distance properly to get portrait shots, or else it will give you normal pictures. The edge detection and depth separation is pretty good, but it's not extraordinary. You can get pretty good portrait shots using front and back camera of this mobile. The wide angle lens in this mobile can be called as good, but not that great. It gives you wide shots when you want it, but don't ask for the details in these pictures as the sensor of the wide angle lens is 8 megapixel. Usually when you take wide angle shots, it looks good on your mobile and that's what matters. But in low light, wide angle lens is not good. Don't use wide angle lens in low light. There is one more lens of 2 megapixel which is used for macro shots. The lens is useful to those who want to take macro shots, and if you use this lens properly, you can get pretty good macro shots. In most of the cases, this lens is not useful, but if you know how to use it effectively, it will be very helpful. When it comes to the low light, Note 8 Pro mobile performs about average. It produces noise more than required and the details in the pictures are not that great. To view the pictures in the phone, they look good. When you turn on the night mode, it mostly recover all the details and sharpness in the pictures and fill the lights where it mostly required, but it will not reduce the amount of noise in the pictures. This should be resolved using software updates. There are a few more pictures, check them out. Selfies come out pretty good most of the times and it gives pretty good details, but sometimes it smooths out the skin part on your face and makes you look little whitish in color, which is not actual color. Coming to the video department, it can shoot in 1080p and 4K. Both are good in daylight conditions. The quality of the video is really good, but if you shoot in 4K, there is no image stabilization or electronic stabilization. In 1080p, you have electronic image stabilization. So here is the footage. Take a look at it.